So this is something that's always bothered me. It seems like everyone else gets high density, high capacity storage, whether it's USB thumb drives that have been available in capacities as big as, you know, 256 gigs fairly cheaply for years, or even up to a terabyte if you want to spring for one of those Kingston ones. Phones are all the way up to 128 gigs. Micro SD cards, I think, are available in like 256 gig at this point. M-SATA SSDs, I mean, we're talking full-blown SSDs, are available in up to 1 terabyte capacities. So why is it that when it comes to 2.5-inch SSDs for your full-size laptop or your desktop, we've been stuck at the same damn 1 terabyte capacity for so long, with Samsung only recently releasing a 2 terabyte SSD? So in today's video, we're gonna be introducing two things. Number one is the largest SSD that I have ever had my hands on. This is a 3.84 terabyte SSD. And number two is a new format inspired by this thing that we're calling holy sh**. TunnelBear is the easy-to-use VPN service that lets you browse the internet as though you're in one of 20 different countries. Check out the link in the video description to learn more and try it for free. So I think the appropriate way to start something like this, when you got like something really cool and interesting and different, is with one of our classic unboxings. So let's go ahead and rip this baby open and find out what exactly a 3.84 terabyte SSD looks like. Oh, the answer is that aside from the horrendous box with the 3-year warranty policy thing in it, clearly designed for people who don't care about the retail packaging, exactly the same as any other SSD. I mean, okay, sure, you've got the 3.84 terabyte capacity written on there. There's probably some other specs, like there's your power consumption. So it consumes about 4.1 watts of power when it's being written to. It's rated at 540 megabytes per second read, 480 megabytes per second write, and can handle 99,000 IOPS when it comes to random 4K at a Q depth of 32. So that's pretty respectable, but only about 18,000 IOPS, and again, that's 4K random at a Q depth of 32, when it comes to writes, meaning that this is definitely a reads optimized drive. In terms of the form factor, if you check it out, it's got a standard SATA power, standard SATA data. Yes, my friends, everything that's interesting about this drive pretty much is under the hood. So why don't we open it up? Don't know if I'll ever stop appreciating the irony of these kits being called iFixit when they let me use one, because I never use them to fix anything. I'm usually breaking stuff. Whatever, warranties are for chumps anyway. And if I didn't open it up, how would I show you where all the magic blue smoke gets held while the drive is operating? All right, so first thing you're gonna notice, bunch of flash chips. Actually, not that many in the context of how large the drive is. Each one of these is about 480 gigabytes of capacity. Wrap your freaking brain around that. And the way they achieve that is in a couple of ways. First of all, they are TLC flash, which means that they can store 3 bits per cell. That gives better capacity and lower cost per capacity, although you do trade off some write endurance as well as write performance. And then the other one, the big one, is the fact that they are using Samsung's 3D V-NAND with 32 layers of flash memory stacked instead of just relying on Moore's law to continue to spread out all of those cells. So that is what has enabled them to deliver this puppy, both at a reasonable cost and in a reasonable form factor. But of course, there's more technology on board as well. So you're gonna find a tantalum capacitor on here that's going to allow the cache to flush to the NAND chips in the event of a sudden power loss, as well as, well, you won't be able to see it, but inside Samsung's proprietary controller, you'll find some ECC correction technology, as well as wear leveling, trim, and all of that good stuff that allows the drive to perform as well as it does. And this is cool. In spite of the fact that it uses TLC flash, this drive is rated at a 2 million hour mean time between failure and rated at 5,600 terabytes of total data written in within its sort of useful lifespan. So to put that in perspective, that would be writing the entire capacity of this drive, 3.84 terabytes per day for 4 years, every day, before you would use up what Samsung rates it at. But enough about that. Let's go ahead and plug it into a bench and, well, if nothing else, find out if it still works. Basically what I'm doing right now is I'm demonstrating exactly how to not benchmark an SSD. And I'm going to copy a file from my SSD onto a RAM disk. So you can see it's actually not going that fast. And the reason for that is that this SSD is not designed for large contiguous file transfers. It is designed rather for something more like the application that we are going to be using it for, which is multiple users hitting it for something like streaming video all at the same time. So these SSDs are going to act as a read cache for our video editors to edit video files off of. So they're going to be scrubbing back and forth through video files. They're going to be asking it for this clip and then that clip, and then, you know, moving through the timeline, adding things, removing things. And that is the kind of workload that something like this is great for, where we will be writing video clips to it, but we'll actually be reading them back many times for every time that we write to them. All right, Linus, so a video about a drive, the cool things about which you can't really demonstrate. Thumbs, actually, hold on. Nope, there are some things I can demonstrate, and one of them is the sheer data density of this. So just for comparison, this is Intel 750 series NVMe SSD. This is a 1.2 terabyte drive. And unlike that drive, what Samsung has managed to do here is within that 7 millimeter form factor, so it'll fit in pretty much any laptop, or certainly any desktop, they have delivered 3.84 terabytes. And that's pretty impressive, but you know, microSD cards, right? Like they're huge. No, this is where it gets really cool. So this is as good as it gets for a hard drive these days. This is almost as good as it gets for even 3.5 inch hard drives now. So to put it in perspective, this is about half the capacity of this guy right here. Very cool, but not actually the coolest thing about it. The coolest thing about this puppy is the cost per gigabyte. And you guys are like, oh yeah, I knew he was coming to this eventually. How much does it cost? So this guy right here is gonna set you back about $2,200. To which most of you are probably gonna go, excuse me? And you're gonna tell me this is a value in terms of cost per gigabyte? Yeah, actually, because while I'm not here to tell you guys that you should all run out and buy one of these today so you can keep all your Steam games on one SSD. Yay, because most games' loading times are not even any faster on faster storage. No. Where the cost per gigabyte benefit comes in is in the sheer density of it. Like in a data center application, let's say Netflix, for example, wants to roll out, you know, racks on racks on racks of new servers with, you know, all the latest, hey, say for example, cool movies that you and all your friends want to watch. Well, rather than just the cost of this guy to worry about, and it's only about 55 cents per gig, which is pretty good, especially given like a few years ago we were paying over a dollar. There's more to worry about than just this cost. There's the cost of the drive cage it sits in, the cost of the SATA controller that controls that cage, the cost of the CPU that runs that system, the cost of the actual real estate inside a data center that that server has to sit inside. So if you can double the amount of storage that, again, someone like a video streaming service can have per drive sled, you are gonna have a whole lot of folks saying, shut up and take my money. And that is the most impressive thing about this puppy. But what's the application to you might ask? Well, right now, not a whole lot. Like I said, I'm not recommending that you run out and buy one of these. Although if you are a baller, then you could certainly do a lot worse. No, the applicability to you is that bleeding edge hardware like this always starts in the enterprise space, and within whether it's 2 years or 10 years, eventually makes its way down to the consumer level. So the fact that it's finally started, we finally have SSDs that not only even on a density level, but also just on a sheer capacity level are catching up to hard drives, means that that can't be that far away. So this is cool. We've actually got a giveaway to announce. We've collaborated with Rocket, makers of gaming peripherals, to give away not one, not two, not three, not four, not five, not six, not seven, but eight of their gaming mice. So there's a couple of different models, and depending on how you get drawn, by the way, you enter at the link to the forum in the video description, you can win either a Cairo, which has a 2000 DPI sensor up to 4000 stable with their overdrive mode, as well as a clean ergonomic design, a soft touch surface, and a design that is optimized for both right and left-handed use, or you could win yourself a Kova. So that features their ProOptic R6 sensor, which is a 3500 DPI sensor, which can handle up to 7000 with their overdrive mode. It's got their SmartCast intuitive button layout that doubles the standard M1 and M2 functions. It features two levels, 16.8 million multicolor illumination on the scroll wheel and the mouse rim, and that one is designed to be ambidextrous as well. So head over to the link in the video description and leave a comment on the video saying, hey, thanks Rocket, we love these kinds of giveaways. You should do more of them because they're freaking awesome. But don't wait. You've only got 7 days to enter, starting from the post date of this video. So get on it. All right, guys, so thanks for watching this first episode of Holy Shit, it's just a cool product. Let us know if you like this format. It's kind of similar to our old unboxing format, but we're really gonna stay focused on stuff that really is sort of out of this world. So let us know if you wanna see more of it. If you disliked the video, though, hit the dislike button. If you liked it, hit like. If you really liked it, get subscribed, maybe even consider contributing by using our Amazon affiliate code to buy stuff. There's instructions for how to do that up there. Buying a cool shirt like this one, or even just giving us a contribution through our form. You get a cool little contributor badge. And I think that pretty much wraps it up, so thanks again for watching. Oh, and if you're looking for something else to watch, don't miss any of our awesome CES 2015 coverage. We're gonna have some highlights maybe also linked up there in like a playlist or something like that. Lots of cool stuff at the show this year, which if you're watching this video on Vessel won't make any sense because you'll have watched this before our CES coverage starts, but don't worry too much about that.